Good morning, students. In the previous class, already we are completed the integration chapter. From today, we are going to start a new module, module number 2, that is RDBMS, Relational Database Management System. Okay, the Relational Database Management System is very important for your syllabus. And followed by this, there is a module called as SQL, where we have to write the queries, and those queries are asked for case study in your final exam. So we have to concentrate more on these two modules, RDBMS as well as module number 3, SQL. Okay. RDBMS stands for Relational Database Management System. Okay. Before going to study or know the meaning of RDBMS, first let us start from the word data. What is the meaning of the term data? Most of you may know the meaning of the term data and information. Another term is information. The meaning and difference between these two terms is very important. One is data. Data can be defined as the raw information, or it may not give the meaningful thing to its recipient. But the information is the processed data. Processed data means by using different operation, data is going to be converted into the information. When it is in the processed form, then it is giving a specific meaning to its interested party or the recipient. Okay, so we have to collect the data from different sources, store it in one place, then we have to process it, and we have to convert it into information so that it is possible to give the definite meaning to its recipient. It is useful for its recipient. So we have to convert the data into the information. Now the term data is over. Let us see, what do you mean by database? Okay, next term is database. Okay, database means it is the memory area where we are going to store the records. Okay, here we have to collect the information from the different sources. Those interrelated information, integrated information, must be stored in the computer memory for the future users. That area is called as the database. Okay, for example, MES can be considered as a database. In that MES database, we can store the number of tables, such as the commerce, information about the commerce college, information about the arts college, science, the law college, ITI, polytechnic, like that. Different informations can be stored in the tabular format in the database. But a database is the broader area or the memory area where all the informations are stored in the organized format, systematic format. Okay, so that they can be, that information can be used for the further use. Okay, whenever required, on the timely basis, that information can be used. Okay, it is the memory area where the records are stored in the organized format. Okay, interrelated data is stored in the particular specified format, that is called as the database. Okay, now let us consider the term DBMS. Next term is DBMS. DBMS stands for Database Management System. Okay, the Database Management System is a software. Okay, Database Management System is a software which is responsible for creating or defining the database. Not only for creating and defining the database, which is also responsible for management of that database. What do you mean by management? Okay, once you are created the database, for example, if a table you are created, okay, if a table you are created, just by creating a blank table, task is not over. Okay, for example, a student table if you are created means, in the student table, say it is created using the columns such as roll number, name, gender, डेट ऑफ बर्थ, ओके, डिफरेंट स्टूडेंट मार्क्स, सब्जेक्ट मार्क्स एज वेल एज द परसेंटेज मीन्स, ओके. इफ यू आर क्रिएटेड अ ब्लैंक टेबल, टास्क इज नॉट ओवर. नेक्स्ट व्हाट यू हैव टू डू, वी हैव टू मैनेज दैट मीन्स इंसर्टिंग द रिकॉर्ड्स, ओके, इंसर्टिंग द रिकॉर्ड्स इन टू द टेबल. से इफ इट इज बिकम फिफ्थ सेमेस्टर स्टूडेंट्स, से 30 student records we have to enter, isn't it? If it is A division students, say 110 students records we have to enter, okay, adding the records, okay, then it is also required to delete one or more records, okay, it is required to retrieve the records depending upon our requirements, retrieve or select the records on these requirements means display the records of students who are passed in distinction, display the records of male student, okay, display the records of those students whose name starts from S, like this. Depending upon your requirement, you have to write the queries, okay. Any type of task, it is possible to display that, retrieve that depending upon our requirement, okay. Or the task such as changing the structure of the table. Changing the structure of the table means what? Initially, while creating the table, if email address is not included in the table, okay, only say phone number is included. I don't want the phone number. I want the email address means another column we have to add. That is called as changing the structure of the table, adding the extra column, deleting the existing column, or changing the data type. Okay, for example, say register number is declared in number data type, later I want to change it into character, then that is modification. Okay, that is also a part of management. Okay, or changing the field width. Okay, all those tasks can be performed by using database management system. Okay, just what you have to remember for the time being is that it is a software which is responsible for creating or defining the database plus management of the database. Okay, management of the database includes inserting the records, okay, then deletion of one or more records, then retrieve the data on the selective basis. According to the requirement, we can retrieve the data, then we can change the structure of the table, means we can add the columns, we can delete the column, we can change the field width, etc. And finally, it is possible to delete the entire table. All those tasks are performed by database management system. Okay, now this part is also completed. Data, database, database management system. Okay, data is the raw information, information is, data is converted into the processed information. Database is the memory area where all the interrelated data is stored in the organized format. Then a database management system is a software which is responsible for creating or defining the database plus the management task such as addition of records, then selective display of the records, okay, then updating the records, okay, adding the columns, deletion of the columns, changing the field width, deletion of the entire table, all those tasks DBMS perform. Finally, let us consider R. R means relation or relational, okay, relational database management system. In the relational database management system, the basic data structure we are using is a relation or a table. Relation means table here. Okay, in the simple term, relation is nothing but a table. In RDBMS, the data which we are collected is stored in the tabular format. Okay, illi records anna now table format alli store maartive. Okay, enannu store maadbekadre now table format nallene store maartive. Means we are going to store in the tabular format only, whether it is student records, student table we have to create. If it is employee records, employee table we have to create. If it is product records, product table we have to create. Like that, any information if you want to store, that must be in the tabular format. But here we are not using the term table. The tables are referred as relation. In the relational database management system, the term relation is nothing but a table, but don't use the term table here. Table is referred as relation. In the relation, the columns of the relation, for example, in the student table, roll number, name, gender, डेट ऑफ बर्थ, सब्जेक्ट मार्क्स, टोटल मार्क्स, परसेंटेज, ऑल दीज आर द कॉलम्स, इजंट इट? दीज कॉलम्स आर कॉल्ड एज एट्रीब्यूट्स. कॉलम्स आर कॉल्ड एज एट्रीब्यूट्स. दीज एट्रीब्यूट्स आर नथिंग बट प्रॉपर्टीज और कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स. Okay, these are the properties, isn't it? For example, the date of birth is a property of the student. Okay, property means characteristic. Okay, characteristics of the student. Roll number is the characteristics of the student. Okay, just by using roll number, it is possible to identify a student uniquely, isn't it? Similarly, say, in case of employee database, designation is a property, department is a property, salary is a property, isn't it? In case of the product database, product ID, you can consider product ID, price, quantity, color, like this. Different attributes we have to consider. Columns are nothing but attributes. Similarly, row, the row of the relation or row of the table are referred as tuples. Okay? Rows of the table are referred as tuples. These are nothing but the records. Student records are referred as tuples. Employee records or rows are called as tuples. Okay, that these common terms we have to remember. This is the example. Okay, this is the simple introduction part for the relational database management system. Okay, for example, say, if I ask you what is your percentage, okay, I need a specific information there, isn't it? I need the information about your percentage. What you have to tell me? You have to tell me the final percentage. Say 85% or 80, 82, like you have to tell me. But to get that, some processing work is required, isn't it? What is the information required for that? The information, some information is required to get that percentage. Means to get the percentage, we need the student marks, isn't it? Different subject marks are required. Those subject marks we have to collect, then we have to add that, then we are going to get the total marks. Okay, that total marks, when it is divided by number of subjects, then we are going to get the percentage, isn't it? Here, that is the difference between data and information. Subject marks may be considered as data and percentage may be considered as the information. Like that, we need a specific information, okay? Our organization need the specific information. To prepare that specific information, what we have to do is, we have to collect the data or input from different sources, okay? That data is stored in the database in the organized format. Then using a software called as database management system, it is possible to do several tasks on that. Then depending on our requirement, okay, whenever required, we can display it in the specific format. Output we can get by executing the queries. Okay, this is about the initial introduction of relational database management system. In the next class, let us see the concept of entities and relationship. Thank you.